I believe that the Islam religion is the best religion for our people.
إن الإسلام بدا غريبا.
إنما دعوة إسلامية.
فرأيت النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على عبده ورسوله وصحبته من خلقه وأمينه على وحيه نبينا وإمامنا وسيدنا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه.
Perhaps one of the most eminent and established scholars of contemporary times to have graced the Muslim world, Shaykh Abdul Aziz bin Baz's life has become a golden standard against which the achievements and works of subsequent scholars is measured against. Born in the city of Riyadh on November the 10th in the year 1912, Abdul Aziz, the son of Abdullah, became the torchbearer for a new generation of scholars in a long line of descendants from a righteous and sagacious household that was distinguished by their noble and virtuous pursuit of knowledge and understanding. However, within just 3 years of his birth, the infant became an orphan following the death of his beloved father, Abdullah. Like the story of so many enlightened souls of old, the flickering flames of greatness that could so easily have been forever extinguished in the midst of a whirlwind of emotions was nevertheless preserved and perfected by the protective and loving sanctuary that can only be granted under the care of one's own mother. Shaykh Abdul Aziz bin Abdullah bin Abdul Rahman bin Muhammad bin Abdullah al-Baz was the late Grand Mufti of Saudi Arabia. He embarked on his life journey in search of knowledge from his earliest childhood memories. Having inherited his family's legacy of scholarship and the love of knowledge, the prepubescent seeker of light exerted himself in the arduous and noble study of the glorious Qur'an, eventually committing the entire book to memory. The teenage prodigy took to work very early on in life, as was customary of the people in that day and age. Abdul Aziz was barely 14 years of age when he took up a trade in the bustling bazaars of Riyadh as an apprentice cloth merchant. However, resulting from his growing love of knowledge and his disinterest in trade and merchandise, the young man soon abandoned the marketplace and committed himself wholly in the pursuit of Islamic sciences under the instruction and guidance of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Sheikh, who would later become the Grand Mufti of Saudi Arabia and a forerunner for his own student. Abdul Aziz bin Baz's love and early pursuit of knowledge grew in radiance, day by day, like a lone star in an empty desert sky. However, as the light of faith and knowledge grew brighter in the horizon, the light of eyesight began to dim. When at the young age of 15 years old, Abdul Aziz began to suffer from weakening eyesight. The gradual deterioration in his vision lasted approximately 4 years, and by the age of 19 years old, the young student of knowledge was completely blinded. This instilled much grief and fear in the heart of his mother. Overwhelmed with concern for her son's future, she consolidated her fears and directed them to God in a solemn and sincere prayer, with which she would supplicate on behalf of her son, seeking for him to be granted vision after his blindness. Like the brilliant ornament that decorates the dark heavens above, though the silvery stars shall fade at dawn, the golden sun shall rise and fill the horizon with brilliant light. That which is lost by sight may be gained by wisdom. During the busy and intensive engagement with the rich and luminous sciences and disciplines ranging from jurisprudence, Arabic grammar, morphology, classical literature, poetry, history, prophetic tradition, textual exegesis, among the many more branches of knowledge then available to study, the young apprentice and budding intellect sat at the feet of masters and drank from the spring of scholarship to his heart's content, as was the well-established and accepted tradition of the past generation. Knowledge had to be qualified and attained through recognized and official authorities. Books were a medium through which a teacher would instruct his students. However, no student would be authorized to teach by merely having read books. Shaykh Abdul Aziz bin Baz studied with numerous authoritative and respected scholars, amongst whom were the likes of Shaykh Saleh bin Abdul Aziz and Shaykh Sa'd bin Atiq, both of whom had served as judges in Riyadh. He also studied under Shaykh Hamad bin Faris, who was the trustee of the public treasury, and under the tutelage of Sheikh Sa'd Waqqa al-Bukhari in the city of Mecca. He mastered the science of Qur'an recitation with correct elocution. However, one of his most esteemed mentors and teachers was the late Sheikh Muhammad Ibrahim bin Abdul Latif, a direct descendant of Sheikh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab. Under his mentorship and guidance, the young Abdul Aziz learned various sciences that would prepare him for his imminent rise to the top of the religious establishment in years to come.
جمع العلم بين القرآن وبين الحديث وكان فقيها على مذهب الحنابلة رحمه الله تعالى في أول طلبه العلم ولم يمنعه ذلك بأن يكون واسع الأفق يختار من الأقوال الفقهية أجودها وأقربها إلى الكتاب والسنة فإذا كان عالما بكتاب الله وبسنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وبأقوال الفقهاء وكان أيضا رحمه الله تعالى إضافة إلى علمه كان عاملا وهذه نقطة خطيرة مهمة في حياة العالم.
After a long journey across the vast desert of learning and discipline, Abdul Aziz bin Baz was appointed to the position of judge in Al-Kharj during the year 1938. He was then only 27 years of age, and this would be his first official position, which he would maintain for over a decade. Following his judiciary appointment, the young scholar then took up teaching at the newly established faculty of Sharia in Riyadh. He spent another decade fulfilling his duties up until the inaugural ceremony for the Islamic University of Al-Madinah, where he was promptly employed as a professor. By this time, in 1961, Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Baz had attained the high rank of deputy head to the Grand Mufti, his mentor, Sheikh Muhammad bin Ibrahim al-Sheikh. Though brought up in a humble environment, having to earn a living by trading cloth in a marketplace of Riyadh, Abdul Aziz bin Baz committed himself wholeheartedly and sincerely to the pursuit of religious science and discipline. His meteoric rise through the academic ranks was deserved and duly rewarded. During his many years at the court and classrooms of Saudi Arabia, culminating in his eventual appointment to the post of Grand Mufti in 1994. This was the highest religious office in the land, yet he continued to direct many institutions, such as the Muslim World League. He also headed the Assembly of Jurisprudence, while simultaneously serving on the High Council as deputy for the King. Shaykh Abdul Aziz bin Baz was a true sage and scholar. He combined knowledge of jurisprudence with deep study of prophetic tradition. Despite his blindness, which afflicted him at an early age, the Shaykh had preserved volumes of hadith in his heart. So proficient and precise was he in his citation and references that scribes would review their written work in his presence, while he relied entirely on his memory to correct them. He also provided deep insight into the written work. His grasp of the principles of religion and the law of Sharia were widely acknowledged and exemplified by the fact that while serving on the Council of Fatwa with many senior scholars, his vote was worth that of two scholars, while everybody else was given just one vote. Shaykh Abdul Aziz bin Baz was a scholar who had living ties with the people of his time. His concern for their well-being and prosperity was almost proverbial and well observed amongst his students and acquaintances. His valor and courage before rulers, both within Saudi Arabia and outside the kingdom, has been in several books and documents.
ومن صور العناية أيضا بالمسلمين في كل مكان وأينما حلوا عنايته بالفقراء والضعفاء المسلمين المنقطعين في بلادهم وهذه عجيبة فقد حدث عدد من الأشخاص أنهم كانوا يمرون بقرى في إفريقيا قرى في مجاهل إفريقيا في أواسط إفريقيا فكانوا قد مروا بامرأة قالت لهم من أين أنتم؟ قالوا نحن من السعودية قالت لهم كيف حال الشيخ عبد العزيز قالوا وتعرفينه قالت كيف لا وقد أحاطت بي مشكلة فأرسلت إليه وطلبت منه أن يساعدني فأرسل لي محددا شهريا مصروفا شهريا 1000 ريال كل شهر يصلني وأنا في قريتي هذه رحمه الله تعالى فعجب الناس ودهشوا.
The late Sheikh and Mufti, Abdul Aziz bin Baz, is a reference for many contemporary scholars and a role model for many students aspiring to become doctors of religion through hard work and perseverance. Beyond the golden circle of scholars, many people have benefited from his religious verdict and gained a deeper insight of their religion. Others have benefited from his books and recorded lectures. In fact, many people cite his name in order to strengthen their position as regards religious verdicts.
إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ قُلْ هُوَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هُدًى وَشِفَاءٌ وَيَقُولُ سُبْحَانَهُ ونزلنا عليك الكتاب تبيانا لكل شيء هدى ورحمه وبشرى للمسلمين فالواجب على اهل العلم وعلى طلبه العلم وعلى من يقرا كتاب الله حفظا او نظرا ان يعنى بهذا الكتاب العظيم وان يقبل عليه بكل قلبه دراسه وتدبرا وتعقلا في الاوقات المناسبه من ليله ونهاره واوقات فراغه حتى يستفيد من كلام ربه حتى يعلم مراد ربه حتى يعمل بذلك. يقول سبحانه: كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب. ويقول سبحانه: أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها. فعلى المسلمين عامة وعلى العلماء خاصة وطلبة العلم أن يعنوا بالقرآن العظيم عناية خاصة تامة، تدبرا وتعقلا وإكثارا من تلاوته وطلبا للفائدة ثم العمل. وعند الإشكال يراجع العالم زميله ومن لديه فائدة في هذا، ويبحث معه فيما أشكل، ويراجع كتب التفسير المعروفة ففيها خير كثير كابن جرير والبغوي وابن كثير وغيرهم، يراجعها فيما أشكل ويستفيد في حل ما أشكل عليه، ويراجع الأدلة من كتب الغريب وكتب اللغة وشروح الحديث ووصول الفقه ومصطلح الحديث وغير ذلك مما يحتاجه طالب العلم. ومن يقرأ القرآن وليس بعالم سوف يفتح الله عليه إذا تدبر وتعقل، وفي ذلك أيضا رقة لقلبه وقوة لإيمانه وتذكير له بالآخرة وبحق الله، فيزداد علما وهدى وتقوى، ولا يحرم من علم يستفيد وخير يصل إليه.
The light of knowledge and sagacity, from which so many hearts and minds had attained understanding of their faith and the preservation of religion through the course of his tireless efforts to propagate learning and scholarship, came to an end on the morning of May the 13th, 1999. Shaykh Abdul Aziz bin Baz passed away shortly before the Adhan for Fajr. His janazah was attended by an ocean of admirers and well-wishers, both in Mecca and beyond. Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Abdullah bin Abdul Rahman bin Muhammad bin Abdullah al-Baz was a gold mine of knowledge while he lived. But as they lowered his body into the ground and covered him with dust, his legacy continued to shine forth, enriching the living and the subsequent generations, who shall continue to seek his verdicts and teachings, unraveling his legacy like a buried treasure.